because eraser may be just as important as a marker. Marker may be just as important as eraser. But this is a minor component. And because it's just so minor, it's just a spare part, I'm not even using it in my analysis. So this is a must and this is a must. Now, let's look at the example. So this is a familiar sight. You have a car cleaning or car curing tool. The tool is comprised of the handle, of the squeegee, of the brush, and of the scraper. Well, brush and squeegee, they are classifiable in one heading. Scraper is classifiable in a different heading. It is classifiable as parts and accessories of the motor vehicle. Because they are classifiable in two more headings, we have a situation of GRI 3. Analyzing using GRI 3A analysis, is not helpful because rule of relative specificity does not tell us which one is more specific. Is it the brush? Is it the squeegee? Or is it the motor vehicle accessories? We just can't make a determination. Same under the essential character. When you need to, you use this composite tool, when you need to, take the icing off, it's more important for you to use the scraper. But if you need to wash the windshield, of course you use a squeegee. So importance depends on situation. All of them, in other words, are very important. So how do you decide? Here, the essential character rule is kind of difficult to use. It's difficult to use because all of them are equally essential. I think the scraper is just as important as the brush or as the squeegee. You cannot take the ice off with the squeegee. It's kind of difficult to do that with a brush, but scraper is just designed for that. Conversely, you cannot really do the good windshield washing with the scraper. It's just not designed for that. So we have different purposes, and the purposes are so different that it's kind of difficult to compare. Notice they are designed to carry out same activity, to care for the car. And they are sold together. So in this situation, when we're kind of faced with a difficult choice, we go to the GRI 3C. And 3C says we go with the last one in numerical order. And the last one in numerical order would be 9603, which provides for brooms, brushes, and squeegees. Once you apply this category, same thing as you've done with the reporting requirement that I described a minute ago. When you apply 3C, you also need to list all those HTS numbers, with the main one being used for the harmonized tariff schedule. In this case, it would be 9603-9085-50, but still report other HTS, the car accessories HTS, under the system of X's and V's. So that does it for GRI 3. Any questions? Okay. So GRI 3 is a heavy hitter here. So we covered two heavy hitters, GRI 1 and GRI 3. The next one, GRI 4, is really is rarely used. When, if it is used at all in a customs broker exam, it is usually used as the incorrect answer. So the it will be used almost always as a false answer, and it is being used as an incorrect answer because it's very difficult. It's very rarely used by customs to classify things. And the reason is very simple. We know the provision GRI 1 through GRI 3 are broadly construed. We know we have that basket provision as other, which provides for things not elsewhere specified or included, which, for example, are made out of steel. So the product has to be so new, so unique, so extraordinary to be classified under the GRI 4 that it's very rare that you have one, if you have one at all. But in any case, let's read through this. So GRI 4 says goods which cannot be classified in accordance with above rules, with the rules GRI 1 through GRI 3, shall be classified under heading appropriate to the goods to which they are most akin. So what you do is you say, all right, this, even though it's a new product, it's a new item, it is most akin to that product. So you use that product as an example to put your classification in that category. Again, very rare. Here's an example of GRI 4 being used as a false answer. A candle holder into which a candle has been poured is to be classified as a candle. An import specialist has determined that the candle imparts the essential character of the imported item. This is covered by which one of the following GRI? So what do you have? You have, usually it would be like a glass-shaped container. And it will be filled up with paraffin. And in the center it would have this cloth. This the fire stick, right? So the import specialist, again, we see the import specialist. Who is an import specialist? It's the hierarchy within customs, usually at the port level, where customs officer is designed with reviewing products and determining whether it is in fact classifiable as importer or the customs broker declared. So in the fact pattern, we know that the candle imparts the essential character. Right away, what do we know? Well, first of all, without even looking at the answer choices, what are the two rules that deal with essential character? GRI 2A, GRI 3B. This is the only rules where it's mentioned. Possibly, as we shall see, GRI 6 can, by virtue of incorporation, it is possible to use the essential character analysis at the subheading level under the general rule of interpretation 6, which we shall cover in a bit. But the problem here is we are not dealing with subheading, we are not told to the subheading level. And even if there was a subheading analysis, It is really not the best answer because more direct reference to the essential character is only found in those two places. That's it. So I do not see GRI 2A in the answer choice. But I do see GRI 3B. So what does that mean to me? That means 3B is my guy, right? Notice GRI 4, wrong answer choice. Almost always will be wrong answer choice. Unless, of course, customs examiners really provide you with that statement where they go up and they say, what general rule interpretation provides for, and they go this word for word. Goods which cannot be classified according to the above rule shall be classified according to the goods which they are most akin. And in that case, this is an easy answer because only GRI 4 says, refers to the goods which cannot be classified in according to GRIs 1 through 3. All right. Now we get to the very interesting rule, which really stands on its own. It stands on its own because it refers to the packaging material. GRI 5. We very often see things that come in containers. This is, for example, without even thinking about it, we buy water. When we buy water, we usually don't think of us buying water plus a plastic jug. Because plastic jug is just something as a by the way, it comes along. So if we buy a chocolate, right? Let's say we buy a chocolate gift. We don't really think about buying chocolate gift plus a plastic packaging box plus a nice little ornamental string which is aesthetically pleasing. We do not think. We think about buying, for example, a chocolate, some kind of chocolate gift. We do not think of it as buying a box per se. And most likely, once we eat that chocolate part, we'll discard of the plastic component. So really, this because it is normal. It is normal for the products to be sold in some kind of packaging matter, in boxes. Because it is normal for the importers to bring products in which are packaged in the containers, packaged into the boxes, packaged into the bags. The rule, there needs to be some kind of rule that is designed to address the situation of when do I classify packaging separately, or when I just disregard it and I classify packaging as a part of the product. And GRI 5, General Rule of Interpretation 5, deals with this question. Let's take a look. Cameras, camera cases, musical instrument cases, gun cases, drawing instrument cases, necklace cases, similar containers, specially shaped or fitted to contain a specific article, suitable for the long-term use, for which they're intended, shall be classified with such articles of the kind of normally sold therewith. So what is it talking about? Well, it is talking about the articles which are specifically made for that product. So notice, camera cases, musical instrument cases, gun cases, those cases usually have a particular shape. Just as an example, let's see. All right. Do you see those? They have a some of them have the unique shape. Some of them have some kind of unique fit inside. But all those things, they are not just a cheap plastic package.